Beloved in Christ, may the Lord fill your minds and your heart with His peace. Amen. I greet you from the Franciscan Valley of Prayer and Silence. Today is the Tuesday of the 10th week in ordinary time. And as usual, I've come your way with the daily reflections. Today we are reflecting on the first reading from 1 Kings chapter 17 verses 7 to 16. We are reflecting on the theme, an overflow from empty jars. An overflow from empty jars. So we reflect on one of the beautiful passages in the book of Kings, the story of the prophet Elijah and the widow of Zarephath. Reflect on the theme, an overflow from empty jars, that is, an abundance from empty vessels. Beloved, we can experience an overflow from empty vessels only when we have learned to trust in the Word of God. Most of us have given up on the Word of God because we have trusted in different ways and it led us nowhere. Some brought disappointment, some trouble, some disaster, and some even nearly led us to our grave. As a result, we even fear to trust in any other word. But as the difference is evident, those words that brought disappointments and nearly led us to our grave were the words of men. But the word of God is sure and unchanging and will always yield different results from the word of men if we trust in it. Beloved, let us look at instances in the passage that God proved Himself through His Word and how the Word brought about an overflow from empty vessels. There was no rain or dew in the entire land through the Word of God by Elijah. Although Elijah will say in 1 Kings 17 verse 1b that there shall be no rain or dew except by His Word, the truth is that it is not His Word but God's Word. Spoken through him, and we will know that shortly. The word of God spoken by Elijah took effect to the point that it affected the prophet himself. The water dried up at the brook of Cherith, although Elijah declared those words, because they were the words of the Lord, and it had no regard for the territory of the prophet. Since the word was declared to affect the entire land, the word of God is unchanging, beloved. God will later come in again to instruct Elijah by his word to go to the city of Phoenicia in Zarephath. Pay attention, beloved, that Elijah made no move until the Lord instructed him. Moreover, Zarephath was about 100 miles from Cherith, and it was close to Sidon, the home of Jezebel, the very person the prophet was running away from. So God was sending Elijah not just to a Gentile territory, but to the enemy's territory. Who does that? And upon all that, he sent him not to a rich man's house, but to a widow's house to be fed. Widows, beloved, were among the poorest in the land. So how do you expect a widow to feed Elijah? Besides, Zarephath depends on Israel for food. So with the famine and drought, Zarephath wouldn't have food as well. But Elijah obeyed because God was to show him how capable and willing he is to command an overflow from empty vessels through his word. Upon reaching there, Elijah asked for food from the widow. The response of the widow is some kind of pity, and it also proved that she wasn't a believer in Elijah's God. For she said in verse 12a, "As the Lord your God live, I have barely enough to feed myself and my son." But Elijah insisted and said, "Just trust in the words I speak, because it isn't my word but the Lord's." So in the verse 14, Elijah now proved that the words are not his. As he said in chapter 17 verse 1b, "The rains will come only by my word." Now he says, "For thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, you and your household will not lack until the rains come. So just feed me with the little you have." The content in the jar could barely feed a woman. So how on earth will she get something for herself and the son if she feeds the prophet first? Although not a Jew or a believer in Yahweh, she trusted and obeyed. Beloved, God's word doesn't make sense at times. His word at times looks scary if we think of relying on it. His word logically cannot be trustworthy because it is misleading at times. His word at times looks suicidal, but it is the word of God and not the word of man. Beloved, Why would the prophet ask this poor woman to feed him first? Couldn't Elijah be sensitive enough to understand the plight of the widow? Elijah was operating with a divine principle. The woman made two declarations in the verse 12. One, a little oil in a flask or a pitcher. And two, barely a handful of meal in a little jar. Meaning, though little, there was still something in the vessels. For the overflow to come, it is like a new wine which cannot be mixed with an old wine. And to prove the efficacy of his word, the vessels first had to be empty. So the woman first had to empty the vessels, although they will not be empty because of the word of God. Secondly, the woman had to trust, although not a believer. Lastly, the woman had to put God first by feeding the prophet of God. An overflow from empty vessels. The widow's words of a little oil in a flask and a handful of barrel in a grain jar was words of defeat and words of the impossible. They were the direct opposite of the words of the prophet Elijah. For Elijah had a bigger picture. The Lord will feed you and your son till the rains are back. The woman had to trade her words of defeat with the words of God. The word had to empty, or the woman had to empty her vessel in order to receive the overflow from God. Beloved, we mostly look at the smaller picture. We focus on the impossible. We focus on that which cannot change. We look at that which has no life or hope. We focus so much on the weaknesses, but God looks at the bigger picture. Beloved, what are you holding in your hands? What are the contents of your vessels? Are you ready to trust in the word of God to empty it for an overflow? God is commanding abundance from that which is empty. God is restoring you to greater heights. God is about making new grains to sprout from your land. Only you need to trust in Him and be ready to empty your jar. There is nothing like too late in the calendar of God. He will always touch us and grant us our overflow if only we can trust in His word and stay with Him, no matter how long it takes. Once again, greetings from the Valley of Prayer and Silence, and have a spirit-filled day, favored of Yahweh.